In this video, we'll see about the defects cycles relation. Now, what I mean to say is defects is something different, cycles is something different. It is not just one word that is defect cycle. What is the relation between them? Suppose if you have tagged one defect to a particular test set and that test set is assigned to some test cycle. So indirectly, that defect is assigned to the test cycle. They have some relation there. So whenever you log a defect related to that particular test set, the updates will go to that particular cycle. So whatever changes are made to the defect would be reflected into this cycles part. So let us see practically what is the relation of defects and cycles.
So relation between defects and releases, what is the relation here? Now suppose if I create some defects, I'm assigning those defects to my test sets. Test sets are defined and they are linked with the releases and cycles. So right now I'll just go to this defect and you can see there are a few defects which I mentioned. If I go to this testing phase, testing module, if I select this test lab module over here and I have smoke testing. Smoke testing test set has some linked defects. If you observe, there are some linked defects. Now if I go back to this requirement, that is a management, select this option as releases, and if I select the option as cycle one, that is smoke testing, definitely some test sets are aligned to this smoke testing cycle. So if I go to details and if you observe, test set folders assigned to cycle is one. There are requirements assigned to cycle. These are three requirements. Definitely for this test set, I can link some defects. For this requirements, I can link some particular defects. So when you link the defects here, those defects should be reflected into your cycle. That's a cycle one smoke testing here. And if I go back to this quality, and if you observe, I have got some graph over here. That is nothing but the trend with respect to your defects. So today is 30th of May. If you see the 30th of May 2017, and the highest number of defects which I have is nothing but high severity defects. Same way, if I go back on 26th of May 2017, there were zero defects of any severity itself. So gradually when the time was proceeding, the defects kept on increasing. So same way, if you want to filter out, you can just select this options, you can deselect this options, and you can keep on watching the graph. So that the relation between this defects and the releases, or you can say as cycles and the defects, this is the relation between here. So that everything will be reflected into this quality tab. So the reason why I didn't show earlier was because when I was creating a cycle, during that time this tab was completely empty. Now here you can easily understand the relation part. Sometimes if your tab is not visible, if this graph is not visible, make sure you select this configure outstanding defects here, and you have to uncheck this box only targeted defects. You have to uncheck this box and then you have to click on OK. So all the defects would be visible here. Same way, if I click on this functional testing, you can see some defects which have been reflected. But if I go to performance testing and if I click on this refresh, you can see some defects have been linked, whereas on the top the entire graph is totally empty here, right? So I hope you have understood what is the relation between the defects, linking your defects with your test sets and with the requirements. Those will be reflected into your cycles and releases. So I hope you have understood, and that's all for this video.